everyone. It's a real great pleasure to be able to talk about my dance journey. And I really like to thank Geetaka for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, Geetaka. And what is dance to me? Well, is dance about knowing and communicating? Is dance a hidden language of the soul? Is dance a medium to stimulate one's body and mind? Is dance a medium to meet one's physical and spiritual needs? Is dance something that empowers you? So dance can be perceived in many different ways by an individual who learns it. Well, this is the dance that I started learning in 1991 when I joined Kala Mandir Temple of Fine Arts in Singapore. I was living in Singapore at that time. And I had the opportunity to learn from this great guru, Guruvayur Usha Dure. And Srimadi Kamakshi Jayaraman was also part of my dance journey. I was very fortunate to have all these gurus in my life. And in 1995, I did my Bharatanatyam Arangetram in 4 years, within 4 years. But my dance journey just did not, my passion for dance did not just start in 1991. It actually started when I was just 5 years old. When I was at the age of five, I met this beautiful dancer by the name of Shanta Balakrishnan. She was a very beautiful Mohiniyattam dancer. And what I was very intrigued and fascinated by her was her aura as a dancer. She was so beautifully dressed all the time. Even when she used to take her dog out for a walk, she used to be dressed so beautifully in a Kanchipuram sari. And that's when I got this image and impression that, oh, this is how a dancer will look like. So that passion to learn and the interest to learn dance grew more and more. And of course, I only got to learn in 1991. And in 1995, when I was actually preparing for my Arangetram, Bharatanatyam Arangetram, that's when I actually first got introduced to Odissi. That's the first time I met Geetaka also. She came from KL to teach the students in Singapore Odissi. I was so intrigued by the style. It was such a beautiful style. It was the dance form was very unique, and all the more the music was very captivating. It was a very dynamic way of the music of Odyssey was very dynamic and very soul searching. When you hear it itself, you just want to learn the dance form. You immediately feel like you want to be an Odyssey dancer. So Geetaka was very encouraging at the time. She saw my dancing in Bharatanatyam. She took the effort to come all the way to Singapore to be there during my Arangetram day. She gave me such wonderful encouraging comments, and she expressed that she definitely would want to teach me Odyssey. So that was a real honor for me to have her wanting to teach me Odyssey. But of course, only in 1997 when I got married and I came to KL that I started learning Odyssey formally. When I came in 1997, that's the time when TFA was organizing this garland tour program where we were to perform it in different parts of Malaysia. And that's the first time I got to an opportunity to perform the different genres of dance, which was quite alien to me. So that was my first stepping stone actually to become a better dancer. That program gave me loads of opportunities. And when it came to Odyssey, Geetaka selected me to learn to perform Shankarabharanam Pallavi. I was a bit petrified because my vocabulary of Odyssey was still limited and I have not learned so much at that time yet. But Geetaka had so much of confidence in me She knew that I actually know the dance by watching others dance it. So she just gave me this video and told me, okay, Sumathi, just learn from the video. I'm sure you will know how to dance. I have full confidence in you. And that was my start of my journey with such encouraging words from Geetaka. I've learned so much from Geetaka. She's such a fabulous dancer. She's very inspiring to watch. She has taught me that there's no shortcuts to being a good dancer. You have to really work hard. You have to practice a lot. Sincere practice is needed. You have to be sincere and you have to be passionate, and that will take you to become a very good dancer. Along the way, I have met a lot of inspiring dancers, and one of them was Gunalakshmi. When Geetaka had actually featured this program called Odyssey, and there was this particular dancer by the name of Gunalakshmi. Everyone was speaking so much about her, such a fantastic dancer she was. And I still remember it took place in Victoria Theatre in Singapore, and I was sitting beside the side wings at the back of the stage and watching this dancer. And that's when I realized that this dancer, even in the moment of stillness, every limb of her body was still dancing. And that really captivated my heart, and till today it has become a lasting impact in my mind. And I realized that's what the beauty of dance is. And another dancer that really captivated me was Sujata Mohapatra. I remember going to her program in Tun Samandan Auditorium in KL with Geetaka, and there was hardly anybody in the audience. The show wasn't publicized well, so there was hardly anybody. It was just a few of us there. But then out came this majestic dancer, a beautiful majestic dancer. And the way she danced, she was not perturbed at all by the number of audience she had. She just danced her heart out. She danced as though the whole auditorium was filled with audience. That's when I realized that a good dancer dances for themselves, dances for their inner satisfaction, dances for their soul. And that's when I realized what dance is all about. So I've come across so many beautiful dancers in my life who have inspired me. I have learned from many teachers, and presently I'm learning from Ratikan Mohapatra. And all the gurus that I have, who have come in my life, have taught me many precious, priceless things in my life, which till today I carry with me when I teach my students. I impart it to my students, and I never forget and never fail to tell them, this is what I've learned from my teacher, and this has what made me today to who I am now, standing right in front of you. So I owe this so much to all my gurus in my life. What is my achievement? My achievement in life, I have performed so much. I have the opportunity, such great opportunities in my life, to prove myself as a good dancer. I have inspired I would have at least inspired a few in my journey as a dance, and that's an accomplishment. And but today my achievement is what my students' achievement are. I am more a dance teacher now than a performer. When I see my students performing well, when my students achieving well, when I see my students beautifully dancing on the stage, when I hear beautiful comments about my students when they dance, This is the greatest happiness for me. This is the greatest achievement for me as a dancer, because whatever my teacher has given me, the beautiful things in my life, I realize I'm able to impart that to my students. I have done something good in their lives, and that is my greatest achievement in life. Of course, when I was much younger, dancing without much physical issues, health issues, was much easier, you know, to go down full murumandi was so much easier, able to do different stance was so much easier. But now I have so much of limitations when I dance. Certain things I'm not able to do like how I would have done then, you know. But despite that, I do not let it hinder my love for dancing. I work around all these physical and medical issues I have, and I still try to dance as much as I can, carrying forward whatever I had received from my gurus. The little I can make them happy and proud of me will be something that I would be happy in my heart, a fulfillment for me as a dancer. That would be a great fulfillment for me as a dancer. If my teacher see me dancing, still, that if that makes them happy, and that's what I would still would love to carry on doing. So what is my Mother's Day message for all the mothers out there? My message to all of them is, as mothers, we carry so much of responsibilities in our life. For us, our kids are the priority. Our husband is our priority, you know. But nevertheless, we as mothers, we as women, should never give up on doing what we are passionate about. We should find some ways and medium to achieve our passion, to fulfill our passion. So nothing is impossible. Women are strong people. We can do whatever our heart and mind tells us to do. So we should go out there and do whatever our heart and our passion, fulfill our passion. So as women, that is my message for all the women out there. And for me, I would like to take this opportunity to thank all my gurus for giving me everything precious in my life, and I still need all their blessings in my life to go on and on further in this art and to achieve more and more and to make them happy and proud of me. Thank you once again, Gitaka, for giving me this opportunity.